Dixie Chicks, Goodbye Earl. Marianne and Wanda were the best of friends all through their high school days. Both members of the 4-H club, both active in the FFA. After graduation, Marianne went out looking for a bright new world. Wanda looked all around this town and all she found was Earl. Well, it wasn't 2 weeks after she got married that Wanda started getting abused. She put on dark glasses and long sleeve blouses and makeup to cover her bruise. Well, she finally got the nerve to file for divorce. She let the law take it from there. Earl walked right through that restraining order and put her in intensive care. Right away, Marianne flew away from Atlanta on a red-eyed midnight flight. She held Wanda's hand and they worked out a plan, and it didn't take them long to decide that Earl had to die. Goodbye, Earl. Those Black Eyed Peas, they tasted all right to me. Earl, you feeling weak? Why don't you lay down and sleep, Earl? Ain't it dark? Wrapped up in that tarp, Earl. Cops came by to bring Earl in. They searched the house high and low. And they tipped their hats and said, "Thank you, ladies. If you hear from him, let us know." Well, the weeks went by and spring turned to summer. Summer faded into fall. And it turns out he was a missing person who nobody missed at all. So the girls bought some land at a roadside stand out on Highway 109. They sell Tennessee ham and strawberry jam, and they don't lose any sleep at night, 'cause Earl had to die. Goodbye, Earl. We need a break. Let's go out to the lake, Earl. We'll pack a lunch. It's stuff you in the trunk, Earl. Well, is that all right? Good, let's go for a ride, Earl. Hey! Well, hey, hey, hey. Well, hey, hey, hey. Thanks for watching. Hope you liked it. Have a nice day. Ta-ta.